Hello students, subject income tax. In the previous classes, we have studied in detail about the five heads of income. In today's class, let us understand how to compile all the five heads of income and calculate the total income of a person. Let me show you the proforma and explain it to you in detail. The first head of income is income from salaries. Salaries are again categorized into basic salary, taxable allowances, taxable perquisite, profit in lieu of salary. If we add up all, we get gross salary. From gross salary, if we deduct standard deduction under section 16(1), which is 40,000, number 2, entertainment allowance, under section 16(2), professional tax or tax on employment, section 16(3), we get net taxable salary. Just a recap of what we studied. Can anyone tell me what's an allowance? Any periodic payment in cash other than salary by an employer is known as an allowance. The purpose of payment of these allowances is either to reimburse some of the expenses incurred by the employees. Say for example, house rent allowance, children education allowance, transport allowance, etc. What do you mean by a perquisite? Perquisite may be any benefit or amenity like free use of motor car, rent-free accommodation, club bills of the employee paid by the employer. Fine. So when you add up all the four subheadings, salary, allowances, perks and profit in lieu of salary, you get the gross salary. From that, if you deduct standard deduction, entertainment allowance and professional tax, we get net taxable salary. The second head of income is income from house property. Under income from house property, we have two subsections. A, self-occupied property or house. B, let out property or house. So how do we calculate the tax for a self-occupied house and a let out house? Self-occupied house or property means an assessee or a person, he lives in that property, which means he doesn't get any rent, but the income tax department is giving him a deduction under section 24 for the interest on loan he has taken. So a self-occupied house will always fetch him loss. Let me now explain the let out house. What do you mean by a let out house? A house which is let out for rent. So he will be getting his annual rent less deductions under 24. you get the income from let out house. So when we add the income from the, say, loss from the self-occupied house and the income from the let out house, he gets the net income from house property. The third head of income is profits and gain of business or profession. For calculating income from business, we start with the net profit given in the P&L account. With that, we add all inadmissible expenses and we deduct all non-business incomes, where we get business income. For professional income, we add all professional receipts and minus professional payments. We get professional income. The fourth head of income is capital gains. What do you mean by a capital gain? When a capital asset is sold for a profit, it is called a capital gain. We have two kinds of capital gains. They are short-term capital gain and long-term capital gain. If there is a short-term capital loss, a short-term capital loss can be set off with a long-term capital gain or another short-term capital gain. Whereas a long-term capital loss can be set up only with a long-term capital gain. Otherwise, it has to be carried forward. Sale consideration. How much is the capital asset sold? Less the transfer expenses, we get net consideration. From the net consideration, when we deduct index cost of acquisition and index cost of improvement, we get long-term capital gain. What do you mean by indexing or index cost of acquisition? When it is a long-term capital asset, which means the assessee or a person is holding the asset for more than 3 years, then it is a long-term capital asset. So for all long-term capital assets, we do indexing. Okay, once we get the long-term capital gain, there are various exemptions given, like exemptions under section 54, 54B, 54D, 54EC, etc., etc., which we have seen in detail when we studied the particular topic separately in detail in class. The next long-term capital gain we get, then we get the total capital gain less we carry forward if there is any capital loss. If there is any long-term capital loss, we simply carry it forward to the subsequent years. The balance is taxable capital gain. The fifth head of income is income from other sources. What do you mean by other sources? Those incomes which cannot be fit in with the first four heads of income will come into income from other sources. Again, under income from other sources, they are divided into general income and specific income. Let me give you few examples of general income. General incomes are like royalties received, director sitting fee, income from subletting of a premises taken on lease, salary received by MLAs and MPs, examination remuneration received by a lecturer or professor, etc. What do you mean by specific income? Income by way of interest on securities, casual income like winning from lottery, crossword puzzle, horse races, card game, etc. So these are the incomes which come under specific incomes. So we add up this and the deduction. We deduct expenses allowed under section 57. We get income from other sources. It is done. We have finished entering all the five heads of income. Then what do? We add incomes of other persons. Say for example, a minor child, a dependent person, etc. We get aggregate of income, less set off and carry forward of losses. What is set off? From the five heads of income, if there are any losses in any one head of income, it can be set off with another head of income. What does it mean by carry forward? If you cannot set off a loss in the present assessment year, you can carry forward to the next assessment year. That is called set off and carry forward. Adding all this, we get the gross total income. From the gross total income, we deduct deductions under section 80C to 80U, which has been dealt elaborately in that particular chapter. If we deduct the deductions from gross total income, we get total taxable income. To conclude, we have understood in today's class the proforma for calculation of total income. We have added all the five heads of income, that is income from salary, house property, business or profession, capital gain and income from other sources, less deductions under section 80C to 80U. We get total taxable income. Thank you.